I will be short. I mean, if you are starving, don't worry. I will just to show you how I'm working with biomechanics, how I'm using biomechanics. Not in organoids, I'm enlarging now to the primates, but I mean, it's possible to use this. Biomechanics is the way that we have to study the structure and function of the biological systems, from what we call reality to the creation of a physical model. Before computers, the way to solve this was okay. I don't like this kind of thing that you can realize. Before computers, the models were based on our problems and mean theory, but nowadays maybe some of the talks that there was two or three at least four talks in this meeting that they are using finite element analysis. The big difference between one model and the others is that here we are using the real geometry from CT data. And in the first models, we were simplifying these theoretical, these physical models in lines. In this case, I will use this kind of models, the simple models from more than 100 years ago, to show how it can be used in this kind of thing in primates. What I will do, I'm doing now, is just study the biomechanics of 31 different jaws using this classical biomechanics level problem and relating with the tooth properties. Why? Because all the biomechanics and all the tooth properties are directly related with the diet. This is something that is written in a lot of papers. I'm using the nano thickness from the different papers and also from the data Professor Oleisek and Professor Smith they sent me. I picked up all the data and I just taking the average of each specimen. And the specimens studied are from Berlin and Hamburg. I'm using a phylogenetic analysis. Calculating the signal using the Packel lambda, and well, I will write all the data using the ordinary least square and the phylogenetic generalized least square. What I'm doing is creating the models from the jaws, considering the forces from the master and the temporalis, and considering different positions of the bites. Incisive, hanging, premolar, molar. Just calculating the distance from the points and or the forces and the points and the value of the forces. My input data are the muscle forces and the solution. What I'm solving is just the bite force. And I'm using what is called the mechanical advantage, which is just the bite force by the input force. It's like some kind of effective the efficiency of the joint, something like this. The results I'm obtaining here are more or less similar and others that you can find in the papers from other people. I mean, I'm quite confident with these values. And what I'm doing is just correlating the mechanical advantage with the nano thickness. You can see that, well, in this case, there is a correlation. P-value both in the ordinary and the phylogenetical is okay, but in the others, we are having some problems. And I just was saying, what's happening here? And I realized that there was an outlier. And I used a script to detect this is the outlier. This script is using what is called the Thomson-Tau method. I mean, it's something a mathematical method to check where are the lines. This is the only outlier, and I was trying to study what's happening here. And I realized that the sources of information of papyrus sinus were with uneven values. And okay, maybe that because there were papers with a very high Enamel thickness and other papers with a very small values. And in this case, I decided to remove, and now all the correlation is working properly and with all the values. And you can see that the phylogenetical signal is something that it's practically, well, the regression is practically the same, means that there is no phylogenetical signal. And this is what I'm doing with the extant species, with the current species, and just now I'm putting some extinct primate here to check what's happening. It would be nice to show some hominoid, but I have a student of mathematics doing this, but the results are not ready, and for this reason I'm just using extinct primate, it's Europithecus bamboi. I want to thank Clement Zanoli because he gave me some pictures, gave me the data because it's not published. And just checking the equations I was obtaining here, I put the values. I just created my model, my biomechanical model, and the mechanical advantage gave me the estimated Enamel thickness, and well, there is some kind of, I think that it's a good approximation of the results. Okay, and if we put Europithecus bamboi in the pitch, we can see that here is the place, I mean the lines, we can use these lines as a prediction of the Enamel thickness, or vice versa, if you know the Enamel thickness, we can just try to obtain some of the biomechanical parameters. Okay, as a conclusion, that's some correlation between these properties has been proved with few influence of the phylogeny. We are just the important thing here is that we are correlating the properties of the tooth with the biomechanics of the jaw, which is, of course, there is a biological relationship, but now we are proving this using the theory of from the engineering or from the physics. And the results obtained for the cemented Enamel thickness in the Europithecus are correct. Okay, thank you. If there is any question, I think that we have time.